WikiLeaks documents containing reports of torture in Iraqi prisons have opened old wounds in Baghdad and could damage Prime Minister Maliki's attempts to form a new government. Some of the abuse occurred while he was in power, and he accused WikiLeaks of deliberately timing the release of the 391,000 documents to sabotage his re-election. In the U.S. and Great Britain, the same documents raise questions about why American soldiers reported abuses such as the beating of prisoners, but did not step in to stop it.
U.S. and U.K. forces cannot turn a blind eye on the basis it wasn't their soldiers doing the torturing. And that's what's happened and is revealed in these logs.
Another old wound, the still unfolding tragedy of Iraqi civilians who lost their lives in the 5 years covered by these documents.
We estimate that when fully analyzed, these logs will bring to public knowledge more than 15,000 previously unreported civilian deaths.
U.S. officials did not contest the accuracy of the documents, but instead tore into WikiLeaks for making them public. On his Twitter site, the chairman of the Joint Chiefs called the leak irresponsible and said it puts lives at risk and gives adversaries valuable information. WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange insisted he had bent over backwards to delete sensitive information.
What has been done is now far too redacted. It is, in fact, I would say, a bit of a travesty how over-redacted this material is.
Pentagon officials were especially concerned Assange would reveal the names of some 300 Iraqis who had helped the Americans and might now be subject to reprisal.
We're still reviewing what he's posted on the internet, and it does look as though he has redacted many names of Iraqis.
In one document, WikiLeaks deleted the name of a private security contractor accused of shooting at civilians. The New York Times posted the same document without deleting the name of the now infamous Blackwater.
Modern warfare with its high-tech weapons was supposed to spare civilians. But in Iraq, that turned out to be a false promise. Jeff?
So, David, we saw this first dump of documents from WikiLeaks relating to the Afghan war to begin with, now the Iraq war. Any idea what comes next from WikiLeaks?
They say they have 15,000 more documents on the Afghan war. And although that would be by far the smallest batch of documents that they've released, it could be the most sensitive because these are said to be State Department cables in which American officials are expressing candid opinions about Afghan leaders.
All right, David Martin at the Pentagon tonight. David, thank you very much.